ACMI productions are only made possible with your support. Visit patreon.com/ACMI to learn how you can help. The following program is brought to you by Arlington Community Media, where we tell your story.
This is ACMI News, recognized nationwide as the first place winner of the 2023 Hometown Media Award for News Access.
Excuse me. Passions run high at the May 1st Select Board meeting as several residents weighed in on the townwide call for a ceasefire in the Middle East. ACMI News begins a new series that salutes our veterans. In this newscast, we talk to Bill Hayner, a familiar face in town who had a front row seat to the horrors of the Vietnam War. And once you see the spring-summer lineup at the Regent Theatre, you'll feel nice, like sugar and spice. ACMI News starts right now.
From McLennan Park to Spy Pond, from Poets Corner to the Mystic River, we have Arlington covered, giving you stories that count from people who care. Reliable, trustworthy, dependable. This is the nationwide award-winning ACMI News.
Arlington's May 1st Select Board meeting focused on the continuing Israel-Hamas conflict and that controversial ceasefire resolution due to the go to a special town meeting next week. Hello, I'm June Rutel.
And I'm David Palomar. Glad you could join us. It was a jam-packed Select Board meeting where several speakers had their turn to comment on this sensitive issue. In the end, the board voted 5-0 to report to town meeting on the article without a recommendation. Among other things, Special Town Meeting Article 5 calls for an immediate ceasefire in the Israel-Hamas war and releasing all hostages.
But things got heated roughly an hour into the meeting.
Select Board Chair Stephen DeCourcy had to admonish some residents in the gallery more than once.
The ceasefire resolution is an opportunity for us to be the adults that not only our children need, but also that the children of Gaza desperately need. To reject the logic of collective guilt and punishment, to absolve the children of Gaza from crimes they didn't commit, to say that our tax dollars should not be spent in a way that enables daily atrocities and to affirm peace.
So to divide this thing that it's not about Jews, it's about Israel, that's absolutely wrong. From the very beginning, I was in Arlington 3 years ago, going down Mass Ave, a guy goes down the street and, excuse my language, he pulls down the window and says, you Zionist pig. Why? I was wearing a kippah. There is no distinction between Zionism and Judaism. And that is an important thing to note.
I don't think we should take sides on matters where we have no...
Excuse me.
Anti-genocide.
I ask everybody to be quiet in the room so that Mr. Helmuth can speak.
Thank you. I don't think that we should take a side on matters about which we have no specific local expertise in our role as the policy board for Arlington's government services. Town meeting will have the opportunity to consider this.
Excuse me. Okay, that's twice. We can't have this back and forth. We had our public comment period. It is now time for the board to speak. I'm sorry if you disagree, but if you could please not interrupt the speakers.
I see both sides. I'm not clear which advice to give to town meeting, and rather than give them potentially bad advice, I'd rather give no advice because I feel that each of those town meeting members are
excuse me, this is several times. All right, excuse me. All right, I'm going to call a short recess because if we can't do our business here and have the back and forth, I'm sure. We're going to take a short recess.
The meeting resumed with a unanimous vote to report to town meeting on the article without a recommendation. The board's thinking was that resolutions belong entirely to town meeting. Meanwhile, this week, town meeting members voted to ban the sale of new fur in town and soundly defeated a measure that sought to impose restrictions on protests near any given private residence. You can get the latest on this year's town meeting by going to the town website, arlingtonma.gov/townmeeting. Again, that's arlingtonma.gov/townmeeting. And as always, ACMI will cover town meeting in real time. If you can't make it to Town Hall, watch it right here on ACMI. Just go to acmi.tv.
This year's Spring Fling Arlington Heights is scheduled for Saturday, May 18th. That's where you will find Claire Ricker, Arlington's Director of Planning and Community Development. She will be taking your questions regarding possible changes in zoning in the Heights. Earlier this week, she talked to ACMI's James Milan about changing the proposal, which in some ways would alter the current business landscape of the Heights.
I will be there to provide information and answer questions related to a zoning proposal that the Arlington Redevelopment Board is looking to advance at next year's town meeting in 2025, related to establishing an Arlington Heights business district. So we would take the various levels of B, we call them B districts, that are up in the Heights, and we would combine them into one comprehensive zoning district that better reflects, the current design of the Heights, what future development may look like up there, related to, commercial construction, and those sorts of things. So I will be at the Spring Fling, kind of as a kickoff informational session for folks. I would love it if people would come and ask me some questions about what we're trying to do here.
Again, this topic is for discussion at next year's town meeting. Ms. Ricker will be at this year's Spring Fling, scheduled for May 18th. Find out more about the event on the Chamber of Commerce website, arlcc.org. Again, that's arlcc.org.
The town of Arlington has a new deputy town council. She is Jacqueline Munson, and among other duties, her responsibilities include representing Arlington before courts and administrative agencies and providing legal advice to town departments. She started her new role in March, and according to town manager Jim Feeney, she has already shown a great amount of dedication to the warrant article process and a strong interest in town meeting matters. Prior to coming here, Ms. Munson worked for the City of Boston as Assistant Corporation Counsel and Ethics Advisor. She holds a Bachelor of Arts in Developmental Psychology from Manhattan College and a Juris Doctorate from Northeastern University School of Law.
Are you looking for a new do? Want to change up the look before summer rolls into town? Arlington has a new barbershop opening up on Tuesday, April 23rd, right across the street from Town Hall at 721 Mass Ave. They're putting the finishing touches on Ace Town Barbers, complete with enough chairs to keep waiting time to a minimum. This is the result of a friendship between the new co-owners, Evan and Anthony. And they said they're ready to cut, style, trim, and shampoo you to a new you.
Yeah, me and Anthony, we've been in the barber business for around a decade now. We've been very good friends. We've worked together in the past at another barber shop. So we decided to come together and bring the town Ace Town Barbers.
Really excited now, Tuesday. Really excited to meet everyone in the community and give good haircuts out to everyone.
That sounds good. Now, what are your hours going to be?
We're going to be open pretty much every day besides Monday. Pretty flexible in the morning all the way to night, pretty much, just to get the word out so everyone can get a chance to come in Ace Town Barbers.
And what has the response been in town, though, with your new business opening up? I'm sure a lot of people are enthusiastic to hear about this.
Seems like they're very curious about the business. We see a lot of people peeking through the windows, wondering when we're opening. So this is great. We're doing this interview. And like Anthony said, I've lived in town for about 17, 18 years. Now we're looking forward to doing what we do and connecting with the community in that way.
For more information, including prices and hours of operation, just go to their website, acetownbarbers.com. Again, that's acetownbarbers.com.
ACMI News is now working with area veterans in producing an oral histories project. We are giving our men and women in uniform the opportunity to tell their unique story. From World War II to the present, we are looking for veterans in all branches of the military to recount their own experience serving this nation and how that experience changed their lives forever. In this newscast, we interview Arlington resident Bill Hayner, an Air Force veteran of the Vietnam War. Bill was stationed in Taiwan and Cam Ranh Bay in Vietnam. Here's Bill's story about a young man caught in the turmoil of extremely unpopular conflict half a world away.
Doubt and debate are enlarged because the problems of Vietnam are quite complex.
All my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye.
I was officially stationed in Taiwan, which was in the Vietnam theater, so it counted as service there. 314th Field Maintenance Squadron. Our job with the C-130s was to supply all the material that was necessary for the war effort. They needed a clerk at the connection down there, so I was spent from January of 1969 to June, 2 weeks before I came back, in Cameron Bay. On my off days, I would go on the C-130s and fly around and get experience. I learned to become an assistant loadmaster. I had no official designation, but I would help the loadmasters on the C-130. Got to see the good and the bad and the ugly part of it.
If you've arrived in Vietnam after October 1st, there's a new regulation out that says the name tags on your fatigue uniforms must slant down along the tops of the pockets. So get with it.
When the beer ration would arrive, it seemed to be the only time other than when President Johnson arrived that security was the tightest. Different groups would commandeer some of the supplies. The steak ration, a couple of pallets would disappear every now and then to the different people, and we ate well. Steak that was destined for the officers' club didn't always make it to all the officers' club. We take 50-gallon drums, cut them in half, and make barbecue. One of the fun times, right near my barracks, there were some septic tanks. Well, one night a rocket hit one of those places, and literally there was stuff flying all over the place. And the next morning, it was hilarious. One of the things the C-130s did was called a touch and go. The back of the C-130 opened up, and normally when it was landed, the pallets would slide out on these tracks and stuff and be picked up by forklifts or just slide out. On a touch and go, the moment the plane touched down, it was giving it full throttle to take off again, and the stuff was being pushed out or pulled out by parachutes. A couple of times we were told, everyone move forward, they're drawing fire at the end of the runway. I got up and moved about 10 feet, and right where I was sitting, a hole was blown. And I gotta tell you, I wet my pants, I'll be honest with you. It scared the hell out of me. It was real.
Now the time has come to leave you. One more time, let me kiss you. Then close your eyes, I'll be on my way.
Some of the sad times was when the C-130s would come in and they would be departing with the dead. You'd see the coffins, they'd come in in body bags. I still get chills thinking about that. I was on a plane once that had body bags, and one of the guys got on the plane and he still had a load. I don't remember if it was a pistol or a gun, and he started opening the body bags and he was looking for his friend. And he pulled, somebody tried to stop him, and he turned the gun on him, and somebody talked him down. He was an emotional mess. I don't think any charges were ever filed against him. I think they understood his emotional state and everything. He had lost his best friend. We found that out afterwards.
The peace movement's got to go into the streets, and it's got to use the tactic of disruption, because the American people are drunk with apathy, because they don't care. Our country is now in the situation that Germany was in the 40s. We're committing mass murder.
We gotta get out of this place. If it's the last thing we ever do. We gotta get out of this place. Girl, there's a better life for me and you.
When I came back, that's when it really hit me. The lack of appreciation or the lack of respect. And with the demonstrations going on and stuff, we ignored it. It got to the point where you didn't want to argue. You just ignored it. In 1990-91, the local veterans in Groton wanted to welcome back the Iraqi vets. And a couple of Korean vets and World War II vets said, it's time to welcome back the Vietnam vets. I'm going to get emotional over this, but I don't know how they found our names. We came, and all of a sudden, we're looking around, and I'm looking around. And there's three or four guys that I had been teaching with for over 10 years, and we had never mentioned it. Excuse me. We swore we'd never be ashamed again.
Every place I go, I think of you. Every song I sing for you. When I come back, I'll wear your wedding ring. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. I don't know when I'll be back again. Again. Oh, babe, I hate to go.
And we thank Bill for his extraordinary story. If you are a veteran or know someone who is, we'd love to hear from you. If you would like to be part of this ACMi News Oral Histories project, all you have to do is contact Bill Hayner via email. Bill_Hayner@Comcast.net. Again, that's Bill_Hayner@Comcast.net.
As you already heard, Arlington Spring Fling is just around the corner. Once again, you will find vendors lining Mass Ave in the Heights on Saturday, May 18th. One way Arlington residents will mark this year's event will be celebrating nature. On May 18th, at the Rosa Granella on Mass Ave, there will be several poetry readings. And to tell us all about it is poet and teacher Jesse Braun, who will be this year's MC at the event.
As part of the Arlington Heights Spring Fling Festival, there's going to be a poetry celebration called The Neighborhood of Earth. And we're really lucky because this year we have not only some professional publishing poets, possibly your friends and neighbors from Arlington, but also three youngsters joining us.
That'll be great. And this is a free event?
It's free, 4 to 5 p.m. here in our very own Roasted Granola on May 18th. That's the Saturday. There's a rain date Sunday the 19th if we have to postpone, but come on down. Saturday is going to be great at 4.
You know, if it rains on Sunday, that's fine because we are the neighborhood of Earth.
That's right. And that's the theme of this.
We're
all walking on the same Earth. We go out and it's lifting us up. What lifts you up when you're walking
nature
on the earth? What lifts you up in this very neighborhood? So we're inviting people to bring what lifts them up and what will bring you all liftings when you come to the reading. We're really excited about this. It's an outgrowth of a concert event organized with Cantilena and Jean Flanagan, our poet laureate, about the beauty of the earth and what poets and musicians can bring us to share that beauty. We're just gonna have folks here at 4. We'll probably finish by 5. We may even be reading right here where I'm standing. Totally free, people can come in and enjoy themselves. We'll have a microphone so you'll get to hear your youthful writer friends as well as your adults. There are so many secret poets, writers, performers, musicians in our very own Arlington, and we want to showcase what they do.
And currently, they're looking for volunteers to help with this event. If you're interested, you're asked to email Jesse at poetwork@gmail.com. Again, that's poetwork@gmail.com. The ring date for this year's Spring Fling is set for Sunday, May 19th. And speaking of poetry, I had the honor of interviewing Jane Flanagan this week. Ms. Flanagan is Arlington's fourth Poet Laureate. You may recall she was appointed by Select Board in January 2023. Flanagan is one of the founders of the Arlington Center for the Arts, a linchpin of the artistic community here. What role do you see poetry playing in here at Arlington for local perspectives?
Oh, I think it plays, it could play a bigger, much bigger role than it does. Although, I think that lately a lot of great things have happened. For example, this is my second year giving the invocation at the town meeting, which influences, I hope, a number of people to think about poetry.
Jane Flanagan has been a lifelong poet, using her craft to process complex human experiences. Inspired by Arlington's love for literature, Flanagan has created an anthology showcasing the works of local poets. She shared a few lines with me from her book, Black Lightning, about the Great Famine in Ireland, and the toll it took on the Irish people nearly 200 years ago.
Kathleen boards the ship for Boston, etches this last sunrise in her mind, while the cool wind rocks the ship. A day out to sea, and already sickness, black fever, scarce air, seeping water. Each day the dead are slipped into ice-filled waters. If there were crosses for every dead body from Ireland to Boston, the ocean would be white with them. I think that poetry should be a part of everyone's daily life, of course.
Flanagan recently saw contributions to a planned publication called Anthology of Arlington, Massachusetts Poets. The deadline for submission was Wednesday, May 1st. Flanagan told me she was looking for poems by people who live or work in Arlington now or have spent a good deal of time in Arlington. This ongoing project is sponsored in part by the Arlington Center for the Arts.
This is a sure sign that spring is on the way and nearly here. Registration has already opened for the 28th annual Mystic River Herring Run and Paddle, set for Sunday, May 19th. Everything starts promptly at 9 a.m. at the Blessing of the Bay Boathouse in Somerville. As always, and unlike the fish here, you can run, walk, and or paddle, or volunteer to make sure this event is a success. No matter how you take part, it'll help the Mystic River and surrounding waterways, and you'll be celebrating the return of the river herring. You'll be joining the community of thousands advocating for climate resilience throughout Arlington and Greater Boston. Last year, over 400 people came out to join the Mystic River movement, and organizers hope to top that number in 2024. For more information on this fun event, just go to the Mystic River webpage, mysticriver.org. Again, that's mysticriver.org. This next story comes all the way from Salt Lake City, Utah, and its roots are right here in Arlington. The iconic Angel Moroni statue is once in its picturesque perch atop the historic Salt Lake Temple, 210 feet above Temple Square in Salt Lake City. This majestic work of art was removed from the temple after an earthquake hit that city 4 years ago, restored and replaced earlier this month. So, what's the Arlington connection? Famed sculptor Cyrus Dallin, who lived in this home in Arlington Heights, completed this masterpiece in 1892. He first turned the commission down, saying he didn't believe in angels, but it was Dallin's mother who encouraged him to finish this dignified neoclassical angel. You can see an original copy of the mold of Angel Moroni at the Dallin Museum right here in Arlington at 611 Mass Ave.
Get ready for an online auction courtesy of the Dallin Art Museum. The auction will take place from May 9th to May 19th and will be launched on eBay. The museum currently seeking donations like antiques, memorabilia, handmade items, gift baskets, and gift certificates. For your generous donation, the museum will promote your participation to the thousands of supporters via the museum website, social media platforms, and press releases. Auction proceeds will support the Dallin Museum in its year-round effort, like tours, celebrations, and the annual First Light event, which draws a major crowd at Whitmore Park year after year. To find out more about auction or to donate, you are asked to contact Catherine Lavelle, the museum curator at hlavelle@dallin.org. Again, that's hlavelle@dallin.org.
An Arlington institution is celebrating a very happy birthday this spring. At the tender age of 108, the Regent Theatre celebrated its grand opening in 1916, and since then has remained true to its roots. as a vibrant vaudeville house presenting live music concerts, theater, dance events, family entertainment, comedy, independent films, film festivals, and more. Theater co-owner Leland Stein says the late spring summer lineup will continue to celebrate more than a century-great entertainment.
Right now we're in the midst of a five-week engagement, which is unusual for us because we do more one-off events. It's called The Secret Comedy of Women.
Every woman deserves a good belly laugh. Called Truly Brilliant and Raucously Funny, The Secret Comedy of Women, Girls Only, is a unique theatrical experience that celebrates the humor, truth, and silliness of being female.
It's a fun show, and it's all the way till May 19th, and then we go back to our regularly scheduled programming. And Jeff, do you ever hear of a guitar player named Danny Gatton? Guitar player that could do anything, any genre, bluegrass, jazz, and there's a new documentary film that we're going to be doing the Boston premiere of on June 12th. I'm really excited about it. And the weekend after the 4th of July, we've got something coming in from Madrid called Authentic Flamenco. It's a national tour that's kicking off here, and these are the top of the top of the flamenco dancers and players from Spain. And there's six shows over 3 days, July 5th through 7th. So that's pretty cool. And moving through the summer, a little further into the summer, we've got our friend Tony Wilson, young James Brown, who's celebrating a birthday here on August 14th. Whenever Tony plays, it's an event, and it's an extravaganza, and there will be not only James Brown music, but R&B and blues music and music from the decades. And Tony is a great, great performer who is really carrying on the James Brown tradition, electrifying.
And if you need sunshine on a cloudy day, Motown, the soundtrack of our lives, will be at the Regent on Sunday, June 19th at 5 p.m. for one show only.
Find out all the events happening at the Regent by going to their website, regentstheatre.com. Again, that's regentstheatre.com.
And that'll do it for this week's edition of ACMi News. I'm David Palomar.
And I'm June Rutal. Thanks as always for joining us. Do you want to see how we put the newscast together here in Arlington? Stop by and pay us a visit right here at 85 Park Ave on Thursday afternoons between 3 and 5 p.m.
If you have any news tips for us, stay tuned. In just a few seconds, you'll find out how to contact us.
Meantime, we will see you back here next week. Take care.
You can always check out our latest segments and newscasts on the web at acmi.tv/news. And don't forget to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter and Instagram at ACMi News. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You'll find us at youtube.com/ACMi News. If you have any news tips for us or wish to become a citizen journalist, we'd love to hear from you. Email us at news@acmi.tv or stop by ACMi Studio A at 85 Park Avenue.
ACMi productions are only made possible with your support. Visit patreon.com/ACMi to learn how you can help.